Respected dignitaries on the dais, invited friends from industry, academia, and the startup world. It gives me immense pleasure to share with you the vision that we have for Surti Ideas and Innovation Lab. Honorable Commissioner Sri has already set the ball rolling with the briefing about what the initiatives Surat as a city is taking in terms of developing and expanding the startup ecosystem here in Surat. As you know, it's a very unique initiative by any urban local body so far in India, especially the under the Smart Cities Mission. And therefore, this is going to be kind of benchmark. There are a lot of eyes set on our initiative, and we will sure live up to the expectations. Surti iLab is established to catalyze the innovation and the startup ecosystem for aspiring entrepreneurs and promote growth, entrepreneurship, investment, and employment opportunities in Surat and nearby region. We all know that Surat is the hub of activity and a major center for the region, in the southern Gujarat region, in the Gujarat region as well. And as Commissioner Sri mentioned, it is on the world map in terms of the textile and the diamond. Now, this has been the historical sectors, traditional sectors in which Surat has been leading. With the changing time, how do we integrate the newer technologies so that it can be sustainable and it can also take the opportunities of the further growth? Sort of technology-based initiatives can be integrated to these two industries and also the newer areas. So software as a system, SaaS, then artificial intelligence, big data analysis, machine learning. These are all the new manufacturing technologies which are known generally as the Industry 4.0 version. This is what we plan to integrate through Surti iLab, which is going to be act as a catalytic platform. For this, under the Surat Smart City Development, a wholly owned subsidiary, from an entity perspective, it's a Section 8 company, not-for-profit company, is already established in the name of Surat Ideas and Innovation Lab Foundation. I will just broadly share with you our goals, the timelines, and the deliverables. The idea is to create the culture of innovation and research so that the economic resilience can be developed in a competitive scenario at the national and the international level. We would like to provide the platform for the proof of concept right up to the MVP, as they know it in the startup parlance, which is the minimum viable product. Build the partnership with all the stakeholders through the design thinking approach and connecting with the design thought leaders, and accelerate the go-to-market strategies for the upcoming startups. So we already drawn the roadmap for the next 3-4 years, which will cover several activities going forward, right from the sensitization of the program, operating procedure finalization, industry-defined problem statement. This is very important. This is what we plan to do as with the specific problems of the industry, how those challenges can be thrown up to the startups and the technocrats, and a right solution can be developed, which can be implemented not only here, but across the globe, is what we plan to do. We will create the mentor pool, we'll involve the SMEs and the young mind to work on the problems. We have plans to have the startup clinics, support in design and R&D. We'll also do the funding, mentoring, facilitation, And this is what over a period of time we plan to do. Through the various events, which can cover the Ideas Festival, Peach Day, Outreach Program, Hackathons, Workshops, Design Sprints, Demo Days, Masterclasses, Startup Weekends, and several other ways by which we can promote the startup ecosystem. Our proposed incubation model here is going to be, with the industry at the core and the conventional sector here with the focus area in terms of the textile diamond food processing and also engaging the newer technologies, as I mentioned, through the ideation, prototype building, incubation, mentoring, acceleration, and the trade facilitation. Because business development, we have found, is very, very important activity for a startup to sustain and grow. So the three core areas from a startup perspective, FMB, funding, mentoring, and business development. So for funding, we would like to connect with the GOG, the Government of Gujarat Startup Policies. Gujarat has been a very proactive state in terms of formulating the policies supporting the startups, encouraging the startups. The first policy came in 2015, and that was from the Industry Department, which is a flagship scheme which gives about 20 lakh worth of grant to the startups through the nodal agencies. Then 2016 was the ITITS policy, 2017 is the Student Innovator Policy. We want to use this platform to connect all the startups and these funding mechanisms. In terms of the Government of India Startup Initiatives, AIM, that is Atal Innovation Mission, has been found under Niti Aayog, and they have aimed to set up the Atal Innovation Center. Respected Commissioner, he just mentioned about our Surat getting the top 20 rank in terms of the second round of the Atal Innovation Center applications. So we are fortunate to be in this league, and we will take the full advantage of this. Then there are NIDHI schemes. NIDHI stands for the National Initiative for the Development and Harnessing of Innovation. And there also there are several schemes like NIDHI Entrepreneur in Residence and NIDHI Seed Support System, NIDHI Center of Excellence, NIDHI Prayas for Prototype. There are layered, very good structured schemes, and we would like to act as a catalyst to get these schemes rolling here for the Surat startups and ecosystem. And then we also plan to have the angel investors group engagement with them. We also plan to have the VCs and the PEs, the private equity fund and the venture capitalist. On the mentoring, we plan to do a good mentor pool, and we will also have the tie-up with the national level partners, namely the CAIE of IIM Ahmedabad, then ASCII Hyderabad, various IITs and NITs, National Entrepreneur Network, and international, the Honorable Vice Consul, he just mentioned about Sweden. Now, we all know that in the Scandinavian countries, the biggest country, Sweden, has also very vibrant startup ecosystem. And from this platform, I would request the Vice Consul to have our facilitation for the Swedish startup ecosystem so that we can engage with them for the benefit of both the countries. Then business linkages, the business development support will be through the Chamber of Commerce from here local, Surat, as well as the various other Chamber of Commerce and the industry associations like CII, FICCI, ASSOCHAM, etc. This I mentioned, various activities or the events that we have planned. We have already tied up with some of the major local partners. They are covering various segments, and these are our partners in terms of promoting the Surti iLab and the Surat startup ecosystem. So this is the list of first round of the shortlisted partners. They are representing academia, industry, technology companies, and accelerators and incubators. So with their help, we will take this forward. This is the proposed infrastructure. Phase one, we would have the facility ready, which is a 120-seat co-working space in the existing building, which is getting renovated and refurbished to have the various facilities for catalyzing the startup activities. It will cover 120 seat plus conference room, training lab, and well-equipped auditorium for several events. Going forward, in another couple of years' time, we would have state-of-the-art four-story building, which could be going to be an iconic building from a startup ecosystem point of view anywhere in the country. And that we are sure will catapult Surat on the national map and also on the international map from a startup ecosystem perspective. This is the press coverage. We already spoke about that. So Atal Innovation Mission, we got this grant, which is going to be about 7 crore rupees for the next 5 years. And this will also help propagate our activities. We already drawn the organogram, and soon the people will be in place to take this forward. So this in nutshell is our vision, and thanks to very exemplary leadership and the vision of the Surat Municipal Corporation and its leadership, Honorable Mayor and also the entire team, the Standing Committee Chairman, Commissioner Sri, and the Deputy Commissioner who has become now the Collector of Arvali District, Mr. M. Nagarajan. Through the efforts and vision of all this, Surti iLab has been initiated as a very unique initiative in the country. And we are sure that we will play a very pivotal role in terms of expanding the startup ecosystem and catapult the Surat in the map at national and the international level. Thank you so much.